This will be my 15th opening day. Probably my fondest memory, my daughter, who is now graduated from college, but my very first one was, I think, a first grader sitting on my lap, and I have that picture in my office of my first swearing in. And my mother was there, and my wife was there, and my daughter. So that's probably my fondest memory, that very first one.
He worked, I think, very hard at bringing the caucus together and ensuring that everybody's perspective was heard, that everybody was on board to the extent that we could have everyone on board before he proceeded with a full caucus plan. I think, honestly, that stemmed from his role as a social worker. I think he very much was a legislator that led with social work values, caring for others.
He had a wonderful assistant named Robin McBurney. Robin and I dubbed him the Eagle, and typically I would arrive at the office much earlier than Mr. Bradley, and I would have a list of issues to go over with him. So as soon as Mr. Bradley arrived at his office, Robin would text me and say, "The Eagle has landed." That usually meant, though, that the Eagle had landed and then gone to the third floor and methodically and patiently moved from office to office, checking in with every member of the caucus.
I really consider my role a servant role, so I'm trying to help our members be the best leaders they can be, and so I'm trying to figure out how to best do that.
One of the things that I always appreciated about Senator Bradley was just his calm demeanor and his humor, and he always came to the floor every day with a greeting, clicked his heels, and it was just a disarming gesture and kind of says a lot about the type of person that he was and how he wanted to interact with everybody. And being from partisan staff, that meant a lot to me.
And that while we may at times be polarized in our views, we will not let them paralyze the government functions that so many of our constituents have come to rely on. We pray also that while we may be divided on the processes of government, we will remain united in the purpose of government.
He's always put his community first, his families first. He puts his colleagues first. You know, he always was last. There is so much to say about David. He has been a friend for many, many years, not only here as a colleague here in the Senate, but he's been a personal friend. We've had many, many dinners together. We have shared many, many laughs. He just has such a jovial loveness for life and everything else. So he is absolutely amazing, and I miss him a lot.
It is that sense of honor that there's 7 million people in this state and there's 30 of us. So we represent a lot of people, and a lot of the needs of the state come here before us. So there's that pressure about trying to make the right decision and not really knowing the consequences of it. So I think that's probably one of the more difficult things here.
In the legislature itself, we have some great thing, and one of the greatest things that we have, besides the battles we have with one another, is we have softball. Prior to coming to the Senate, I was a softball player. I played softball with my teams and stuff. Well, lo and behold, Bradley and Biggs and other players, who, I mean, they just loved it. They just loved playing, and that's what brought all of us together. At that point, we weren't D's or R's. We were just all ball players. When I came over to the Senate and playing for the Senate team, the Eagles, well, we started winning, and I was playing third base, and Senator Bradley was our second baseman. We had a great game, and we kept going, and we pulled it out at the end, and there were some cards made, and there's some MVP cards. And when Senator Bradley passed away, I had to go back and look for them, because to a lot of us here in the Senate, he was an MVP to us. And I believe to his family and to anyone that had the chance to ever spend time with him or to at least be around him and hear the words that he would preach, and because they came from his heart, I think he was an MVP not only on the field but in life.
Yeah. I think that's it.
That's it. No, yeah.
Yeah. Right. Thank you for your time. I really appreciate
it. He's out of here. Welcome back to the 7th edition of Canyonside Chats with the Democratic Caucus. I'm Dave Bradley, the leader of the Democratic Caucus here in the Senate, and I'm joined today.
Our second
It had to happen eventually.
It's me.
Which has our vision of the state and get a glimpse of what Arizona could be. Please click the down.
Can we just start the whole thing over?
Welcome to the special edition of the Canyonside Chants. Chants. good day. We're going to sing.
Red Arizona sky, burning in your eyes. You look at me, babe, I want to catch on fire. It's buried in my soul, like California gold. You found the light in me that I couldn't find. So when I'm all choked up but I can't find the words, every time we say goodbye, baby, it hurts. When the sun goes down and the band won't play, I'll always remember us this way.